so thrilled to finally be doing this cage tour for my new DIY cage, and it feels like it's been so long since I had started planning this, and now it's finally done. Currently, I don't have a hamster, but I am planning on adopting a hamster when the time feels right for me, so I've just been preparing this cage, and it's all set up and ready to go for whenever I do come across a hamster. I'm gonna go ahead and get started on this cage tour. This is most likely going to be a very detailed cage tour because there's so much in this cage that I want to show. So we'll go ahead and get started here over in the left corner. So in the front, you'll notice this window, and this is one of my favorite parts about the cage. This is a giant PVC pipe, and I got a giant size to allow a hamster the room to move around in there, especially if I get a Syrian hamster, and bring bedding, and it's basically like a little underground tunnel system. And I'm gonna insert a photo of what it looked like before I added the bedding. But there is an entrance and two exits in this. So the entrance is over here, and I have it covered up with a piece of cork to make it a little bit more private. And the hamster can go down in there. I have this window that I'm able to peek in, and then they can exit out this side over here, or they can exit in the back, which is mostly covered up with bedding, but they can very easily just push it out with their nose if they want to go out that way. Inside of the tunnel, I'm using KT Clean and Cozy, which is the camo color. And then all around the cage, especially in this particular area, you'll notice that I have various types of substrates that I'm using. The main one is aspen wood bedding. And then I have some KT Clean and Cozy. I'm using both the camo color, which is the green, and then I have some apple orchard, which are the red pieces. I also have some KT soft granules and some soft stemmed orchard grass, which has been layered like you see here. Of the cage, there is a giant piece of grapevine driftwood that you guys will most likely remember from a past haul that I did, and I just have it sectioning off this area of bark. Now, this is 100% coconut fiber bark, which is perfectly safe for hamsters. You don't want to go out and just get normal bark, but I think it looks really cool in this cage scene. I also have this polyresin reptile watering dish, which I'm going to try out. So it has a water bottle inside, and then the water just comes out into this little dish. I'm gonna see how it works. If it doesn't work that great or the hamster doesn't use it, then I will take it out. There is this tree that I made, which is a manzanita bird perch with a reptile moss pillow on the top. I do have it weighed down on the bottom so that it can't tip over. I have this hermit crab watering dish, which I'm pretending is a little pool of water because, you know, we're in a rainforest. Back, I really like this section. This is a wooden DIY platform that you guys will also remember from a past vlog, and I just glued some wooden sticks on them from the pet department, and then I wanted to protect the top so that the hamster couldn't get their paws stuck in it, so what I did was I glued on some reptile moss across the top. Underneath the platform I have a square terracotta little hideout, and it's kind of overgrown like a jungle under here. I put some brown eco bedding crinkles. So let's talk about the middle of the cage now, and then we can move over to the right side, which has some really awesome things that I can't wait to show you guys. So in the middle, I put this extra large hobble hut. It's basically like a half log, and the hamster is able to go underneath it, or they can go on top of it. Now, I put this in the middle of the cage for a very specific reason, to allow me to be able to put my hand on it and lean on it if I need to reach in the back, because this is a wide cage and I wouldn't be able to reach into the back middle part otherwise. So this log is sturdy enough. The bedding in this particular area near the log is very shallow as well. You don't want to have heavy toys on top of deep bedding because the hamster could burrow underneath. There's also an extra long cork log that is just laying across the top of the hobble hut. So over here I have a glass fish bowl that I have tipped on its side, and I'm using it as a sand dish for the hamster to go in. Okay, we're going to move over to the right side now, and I don't even know where to start, so I'm just going to start over by this coconut that is hanging up over here. So this is one of my favorite parts of the cage as well. and it just looks so jungly. And then this is the wooden staircase that I made with little log pieces that I found at a bird store. I glued them together with some Elmer's glue. It's very secure. I have it stabilized in two or three different places. This is just some green reptile moss that is on a bark log, and I put it up here to make like a second level. Underneath that, it's a little bit hard to see, but there is this polyresin tree trunk hideout, and I think the hamster is probably going to like sleeping in here because it's pretty dark and cozy. I also have this very big desert rock formation. This is another polyresin item, and it has some holes on the backside that the hamster can also go into, so it makes yet another little hiding place. There's so many little nooks and crannies in this cage that are hard to show. The back right corner of the cage has a Carolina Storm Express wheel, and I decided to go ahead and put this wheel in, even though I don't know if I'm going to get a dwarf or a Syrian when I adopt. You'll also notice the substrate in this corner. This is some more of the 100% coconut fiber bark that I told you about earlier. This front right corner is another special area about the cage. This is a digging box, and inside this I'm using some eco earth, which again is coconut fiber, except that this time it's not the bark, it's actually very finely shredded, so it's kind of very similar to soil, I guess. And it's so soft. If I were a hamster, I would love to dig around in this. And then leading out, there is this polyresin reptile ramp. These bendy bridges have rocks that have been glued on with aquarium silicone, and that just protects the hamster's legs from getting caught in any gaps. So this is just a good idea on how to make it a little bit safer. So I'm probably going to talk more about this cage as time goes on, but the bedding that I had mentioned at the beginning, I said that I had it limited to a specific area, and part of that is because I'm not sure the personality of the hamster that I'm going to be adopting, and I just feel a little bit safer being able to keep an eye on them at first and not worrying about them like burrowing in who knows where. I just felt better keeping it limited to specific areas, and then the rest of the cage has less bedding. The other reason, like I had mentioned as well, is because I do have some heavy items in this cage and it wouldn't be safe for me to have deep bedding in those particular areas. So I'm gonna try this out and see how it works, and I think it's gonna be great. As far as how I built this cage, I still am hoping to be able to put together a video. It does take a lot of energy to put those types of videos together, so I'm just doing it as I'm up to it, and then in between I'm gonna have some shorter, easier, fun videos that are not related to the cage. But anyways, I thank you guys so much for watching this, for your support while I was building the cage. It definitely encouraged me and kept me going, and I can't wait to see what other themes that I do in this cage in future. Now, I don't plan on changing it often at all because it's a lot of work to put it together, and I also just think for a cage this size it would be too confusing to the hamster to switch it that often. So I'm just going to change it when I feel like it needs to be changed, if ever, during the hamster's lifespan. We'll see how that goes, but I'm gonna go ahead and end this here. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!